China's ex-security chief Zhu Yongkang has been jailed for life, the most senior politician to face corruption charges under communist rule. He was found guilty of bribery, abuse of power and intentionally disclosing national secrets, China's official Xinhua news agency reports. Until his retirement in 2012, Mr. Zhu was one of China's most powerful men. He was put under investigation 1 year later as part of President Xi Jinping's major anti-corruption campaign. State TV showed a clip of Mr. Zhu pleading guilty at a closed-door trial in the northern city of Tianjin. When responding to the judge, he said he would not launch an appeal. "I've realized the harm I've caused to the party and the people. I plead guilty and I regret my crimes," he said. The verdict caught many people off guard. It was expected that Zhu Yongqing's trial would be played out for the Chinese public, his failings strung out for every citizen to see. In similar high-profile cases, like that of Mr. Zhu's protege, Bo Xilai, the foreign and Chinese media were given 48 hours' notice that Bo's trial would begin. Reporters camped outside the courthouse for days, breathlessly waiting for updates. In March, the head of China's Supreme People's Court had promised that Zhu Yongqing's trial would be open in accordance with the law. The trial was set to take place in the eastern port city of Tianjin. It seemed Zhu was set to follow Bo's pattern. Like other senior officials convicted of serious crimes, it was expected he would receive a suspended death sentence. Months passed without any word. Some guessed that Zhu Yongqing was not cooperating with prosecutors. Others believed that his crimes were too much of an embarrassment for the government.